NORPAC is one of the largest newsprint facilities in North America. We make over 700,000 tons a year of newsprint. That represents every newspaper that is read in Washington, Oregon, and Idaho every day. Quality starts with the fiber raw material. We have two major sources, TMP, which comes from wood chips, and the ink fiber, which comes from recycled materials, old newsprint, old magazines that we process in our pulp mill.
The recycling process begins with the homeowner sorting their recyclable materials, placing them on the curb for the city and the hauler to engage in the collection of the materials, off to the recycling center where the materials are processed, then sent to the end-use mill for, in our case at the NORPAC mill, manufacturing into new high-quality newsprint.
The value of the old newsprint, it costs more than chips, and it's an expensive product. The largest cost to a recycling plant, the NORPAC, the ink plant, is our raw material, the old newspaper.
NORPAC would like to only pay for fiber-based raw materials. When non-fiber contaminants come into our plant, we have paid fiber value. We have incurred process inefficiency cost of removing those from our system. And then we have to pay landfill costs to dispose of those materials.
We understand the needs of the customer to make things quicker and easier. We understand the needs of the hauler to be more efficient and not waste fuel, be able to use more efficient trucks. The one particular material that just puts it over the edge is glass.
Our greatest message with the work that we're doing today is to help explain just exactly what the glass does to our system.
Glass will come to the plant in large broken pieces or in full bottles.
It's not the big chunks, it's those little chunks that get through. Big chunks become smaller and smaller particles, and they're more and more difficult for the screens to pick up.
The abrasiveness, moving at high RPMs, actually wears holes in the pipes, holes in the pumps, tears up the seals on the equipment, destroys the valve seats on the valves as it eats it away. In the screening systems, the shards of glass will plug up 6,000 slotted.
So one of the most difficulties we have with the glass in the system is going into our sophisticated fine screens. These are 6,000ths of an inch wide slots, so they're very, very tiny, some of the most sophisticated in North America for a news de-inking system. Typically, we replace them every 2 years. Now we're having to doing it at least once a year, replace those things at a tune of about $30,000 to $35,000 a screen cylinder. And we have six of those screens in the process.
Plastics will come through our pulping intact, and we remove the plastics. Milk ducts, for instance. Metal can be detected with metal detectors. It comes out intact. Glass is just pervasive, and it's getting worse.
My biggest headache is cost these days. We're trying to be cost competitive, the cost of the pulp in the mill are going up, and we're fighting to keep them down.
We're probably looking around $1.5 million a year in excess maintenance costs, landfill costs, purchasing the glass as fiber, but never being able, of course, to make paper out of glass.
QIA stands for Quality Inspection Activity. We sort through the bales and separate them into categories. We take a 300-pound sample from every bale and put it on the table, separate our categories, and then separate the glass at the end. We do it to give feedback to the suppliers of what kind of quality of bales we're getting, how much contaminants and prohibitives are in our bales. Well, this is a glass that I have collected out of a 300-pound sample. This isn't even from one full bale. It's just a 300-pound sample. We pour it into here and shake it. All the tiny stuff falls in the bottom. And this is the stuff that gets into the system and plugs it up. This is a tiny little amount for a 300-pound sample compared to the full bale, and then how many bales we get in a day. I mean, if you multiply that by how much we get in, that's a lot.
At the end of the day today, the NORPAC de-ink plant will remove and dispose of in a landfill about 1,200 pounds of glass.
It's a safety hazard too, as we blow down and clean up. glass is blowing everywhere.
Some of the people that we'll talk to today, we'll look at today, have had experience with glass particles in their eyes, a little bit of irritation coming through because of the airborne glass particles. The other big safety issue that we see is having to go into the process, shut down equipment, remove equipment for cleaning or replacement. That is a big safety risk.
When glass comes in with the paper, it's a nightmare for our system. The glass is on the floor, it gets into the air, it becomes a dust that you breathe. On the sort line, you're sorting nice clean paper and suddenly here's a shard of glass and it goes right through your glove.
Yes, we give them gloves and goggles and all the safety equipment they need, but with broken glass in that stream, there's a chance to get hurt.
Oh, recently in the last few years, a lot of municipalities have decided to save money by going to co-mingled recycling. Prior to that, you would separate out the glass from the old newspaper, from the metals.
Well, one of the reasons why it's gotten worse is the communities are trying to reduce their collection costs from the curb, increase the volume coming out of the household, keeping it out of the landfill.
We used to fill up maybe one 10-yard dumpster in a 24-hour period. Now we're filling 8 to 10 10-yard dumpsters. The material that they could be selling as recycled material, Weyerhaeuser is putting into a landfill.
There's a logic for the sustainability of the programs to move toward commingling on the collection end. There's a logic to it. What we want to make sure of is that we don't become so efficient we're just creating garbage.
We would like the municipalities to understand just what the impact of the glass is to a system like NORPAC. If it helps them make decisions around how they do commingling and how they functionally make that work, we're totally behind it, but it needs to work for the end user too.
Well, one of the things that we'd like to see, every opportunity that either the communities have or our suppliers have, is to do whatever they can to keep glass out of the fiber stream.
I'd like to remind everyone that we're in the business of buying ONP, old newsprint, number 8, at a spec of 0.25% or 1%, and that's not 1,200 pounds a day of glass.
The quality issues are paramount right now. It's going to decide if our business stays open or not. If the mills don't want our product, then we don't serve a purpose any longer.
We've spent a considerable amount of money investing in equipment that tries to take this material out.
We're going to continue to give good quality feedback to suppliers directly from the NORPAC. You saw the sorting system up there, that they provide good quality feedback to suppliers. And we're also going to try to educate the municipalities of what the issues of this problem are and how it can affect the end user.
If we could do anything, increasing the quality of the raw material would benefit both the supplier of the raw material and Weyerhaeuser. It should be working together towards a common goal.
I hope what we all get from this program is a spirit of cooperation, a focus on quality, and a way for us to cost effectively to work together to keep this renewable resource recycling over and over again.
We're all in the recycling process together. We're trying to do something here in the interest of being better environmental stewards, and that means we all need to be focused on the quality of those materials in the interest of diverting the recyclable commodities from landfilling, in the interest of creating new recycled content products. And we'd like to thank everyone participating in the process, all of our suppliers and vendors, for being focused on quality and working with us to create a successful recycling story.